Het aroma rood.
Dit is Warren Jeffs, de leider van een sekte die aan polygamie doet. Er wordt gezegd dat hij tenminste 80 vrouwen heeft, meer dan 200 kinderen en ongeveer 10.000 volgelingen die hem profeet noemen. Hij wordt ook gezocht door de FBI. Er staat een prijs op zijn hoofd.
The man is a despot, the man is a criminal, and we have not been successful in locating him.
Hij wordt gezocht wegens het uithuwelijken van minderjarige meisjes aan oudere getrouwde mannen. En nu beweert een neef van Jeffs dat hij door hem is verkracht op 5-jarige leeftijd.
He said this is God's will and this is a way for you to become a man.
Bovendien zijn deskundigen bang dat hij zijn volgelingen zal aanzetten tot een massale zelfmoord, net als in Waco is gebeurd.
Jeffs has stockpiled weapons, thousands of rounds of ammunition and dynamite.
Hij houdt zich schuil. Waar is de man met 80 vrouwen? Dit is Sanjeev Bhattacharya, een Britse journalist die in Los Angeles woont. Hij houdt zich al 2 jaar fanatiek bezig met Warren Jeffs.
The FBI consider him to be a sexual deviant and a criminal. But 10,000 people consider him to be in direct contact with God. So if nothing else, he's one of the most misunderstood men out there and I want to find out who he is.
Sanjeev is in het verhaal gedoken en hij is erachter gekomen dat de 50-jarige Jeffs zichzelf heeft uitgeroepen tot profeet van een groep polygamisten die zich Fundamentalistische Kerk van Jezus Christus van de Heilige der Laatste Dagen noemt, oftewel FLDS. De groep splitste zich in 1890 af van de Mormonen.
That many wives, that many children, that many cousins. Somebody's got to know where he is. There's got to be a crack in that armor somewhere.
Wat is het voor man die 80 vrouwen heeft? Wie is de echte Warren Jeffs? Er is maar één manier om daarachter te komen. Sanjeev gaat naar hem op zoek. Warren Jeffs is al ruim een jaar niet in het openbaar gezien. Hij zou zich overal in Amerika kunnen schuilhouden. Sanjeev gaat als eerste naar de plek waar Jeffs het laatste gezien is. Daar waar de sekte zijn thuisbasis heeft. 6,5 uur rijden vanaf Los Angeles op de grens van Utah en Arizona liggen de twee aaneengesloten steden Colorado City en Hilldale. Samen ook wel bekend onder de naam Short Creek. Hoewel polygamie in de Verenigde Staten officieel verboden is, is de sekte al zo lang actief in de stad dat zelfs de politie, de scholen en de ziekenhuizen in handen zijn van volgelingen van Jeffs. En ze houden niet van pottenkijkers.
I've got to say, I feel a little nervous. I'm not sure what they're going to make of me. I don't think that many brown people with English accents turn up in Short Creek.
Sanjeev beseft al snel dat deze stad totaal afwijkt van andere steden in Amerika.
All the girls are dressed up like Little House on the Prairie. All that's missing are the covered wagons.
En binnen 5 minuten wordt Sanjeev achtervolgd door 2 pick-ups.
They've been following us for about the last mile. This truck turned round. I saw my rearview mirror and has been following us ever since. Why has he done that? Blue pickup truck. He's just pulled his visor in front of his face to cover his face. Why is he doing that? Is he boxing us in or should I continue? I don't understand. Why is he doing that? Why is he blocking us in? Quite aggressive, really.
You know, it's funny, people following you is enough to make you paranoid.
Na de lange autorit wordt Sanjeev niet bepaald met open armen ontvangen. Sanjeev had het vandaag voor gezien en rijdt de stad weer uit. Hij geeft zijn zoektocht niet op. De volgende dag keert hij terug naar Short Creek om meer over de secte te weten te komen. De polygame geloofsgemeenschap woont hier al 75 jaar en er wordt hen geen strobreed in de weg gelegd. Op een gemeenschap van 10.000 mensen komen maar 12 achternamen voor. Sanjeev trekt de stoute schoenen aan en stapt op wat mensen af.
Hallo, sir. We're making a film about Warren Jeffs.
Was that a yes?
I heard.
Why?
Warren Jeffs werd in 2002 leider van de secte. Toen hij in juni 2005 in staat van beschuldiging werd gesteld, was hij al een half jaar uit de openbaarheid verdwenen. Maar hij speelt nog steeds een belangrijke rol in het leven van zijn volgelingen.
He's like God to us. We believe he's as much like God as any man on earth.
He has the attributes of God.
Richard, what does that mean to you?
What does that mean to me?
Yeah.
He's like our savior. He's like Jesus Christ.
Warren Jeffs houdt zich schuil, maar hij heeft de stad nog steeds in zijn macht. Er zijn berichten over mensen die uit de secte zijn gegooid. En er zijn geruchten van seksueel misbruik. Sanjeev is vastbesloten om meer te weten te komen. Short Creek. Een stad met 10.000 inwoners op de grens van Utah en Arizona. Sanjeev is op zoek naar Warren Jeffs, een sekteleider die hier als een god wordt vereerd. Sanjeev wil weten hoe een man een hele stad in zijn macht kan krijgen. Hij heeft een afspraak kunnen regelen met een polygamist. Marvin Wyler kent Warren al zijn hele leven, maar hij verliet de groep toen Warren profeet, ofwel sekteleider, werd.
Come on in. How are you guys?
Very good, thanks. Very good. Well,
volgens Marvin nam Warren de leiding van de gemeenschap op zich na de dood van zijn vader Rulon in 2002. Daarbij nam Warren de ongeveer 50 echtgenotes van zijn vader over.
Warren says, all you men keep your hands off these ladies. And then the next thing I know, why he was marrying as many of them as he could.
His father's wives.
His father's wives.
How many of his father's wives did he marry?
I would guess 10.
Have you met any of Warren's wives?
Well, I knew some before they were married to him.
Oh, but once they were married, then you never saw them?
Never could talk to him again much after that.
What were they like, the ones that you knew?
Well, very nice ladies, very good. They got the cream of the crop, so to speak. Just the ones who were sweet and would be perfectly obedient in all things.
What do you mean, sweet, when you say sweet?
Obedient.
Sweet means obedient, does it?
Yeah, I guess.
Marvin heeft de secte verlaten, maar hij is nog steeds polygamist. Hij heeft 3 vrouwen, 34 kinderen en 110 kleinkinderen. Volgens hem praktiseren de leden van de FLDS polygamie om in een volgend leven een god te kunnen worden. Ook al heeft de reguliere Mormoonse kerk zijn handen afgetrokken van de secte en van polygamie, de secteleden geloven dat het zo in het Boek van Mormon staat.
We figured the God that's over this earth right now, we call him Jehovah or Jesus Christ.
Right.
You've heard of him?
Yeah.
We believe that he was once on an earth just like this one, and he qualified on an earth.
He didn't get married, did he?
Not on here.
Oh,
sure he did.
Did he? Did he marry?
Well, Mary Magdalene for one, Mary and Martha for another.
He had more than one wife?
Oh, yeah.
Jesus?
Yeah.
I definitely missed that bit at school.
You won't get that in the books.
I guess we could dance to this one.
Marvin stelt Sanjeev voor aan Charlotte, zijn tweede vrouw. Ze is niet zijn wettige vrouw, maar ze wordt binnen de gemeenschap wel als een van zijn vrouwen beschouwd. De groep heeft een traditie van uithuwelijking. De profeet beslist wie met wie trouwt.
Is it the case now that Warren Jeffs in this community is still deciding who marries who? Like he has to approve it, otherwise it doesn't happen.
With the people in the Warren Jeffs group, yes.
In that group,
yeah.
So that's how Warren wields power.
He
designates wives to people.
Right, and if you don't get one, why you're in bad shape.
Short Creek houdt de gelederen gesloten ter verdediging van Warren Jeffs, maar er zijn wel degelijk conflicten. Warren heeft mensen uit de groep in de ban gedaan en gebrandmerkt als afvallige. Honderden jongens zijn weggestuurd om minder concurrentie te hebben bij de jonge meisjes.
Would you disown your son because he refused to obey your rules? Would you banish him from your house, from your entire community?
My brother got a hold of me and told me, the prophet wants you out.
Niet alleen jonge jongens, maar ook volwassen mannen en hun gezinnen worden door Warren uitgestoten.
This Hitler-like dictator has got to be stopped before he ruins us all and this beautiful town.
De volgende avond gaat Sanjeev naar Ross Chapman, die samen met zijn vrouw Lori en hun 6 kinderen in de ban is gedaan.
Warren just told everybody that I was a master deceiver and that, in other words, that means have nothing more to do with him.
Are you an apostate?
They consider me one. He didn't really like me because I showed too much independence. Now, the thing he did with me is he said I had wronged somebody in business. I never could find the person that he says I had wronged.
You're both like afraid.
Als een man wordt verstoten, wordt diens vrouw en kinderen gewoonlijk toegewezen aan een andere man.
This is how, part of how they keep this control here. When they're raising your wives and your family up here, you're always supposed to teach them that it's more important to be obedient to the prophet than anything else. Like, that is the most important thing to do.
Lori koos ervoor om bij haar man te blijven. Een ongebruikelijke stap binnen de FLDS, dat maakte ook haar tot afvallige. Het gezin wordt nu door de rest van de gemeenschap gemeden.
I felt like my husband was a good man and he still had whatever good and strength that he'd had before, he still had now. I've never felt sorry for that decision. Warren controls the men by being able to, if they are do what he wants them to, then he'll reward them with more wives. If they do not do what he wants them to, he'll punish them by taking those wives away. So the women are his commodities.
Now, you're not a plural wife.
I'm not.
Would you like to be one of many wives?
And I think 75 wives is too many. I think 10 wives is too many.
Do you think?
Way too many.
How many is okay?
I would think that 4 would be the optimal number.
Right.
At this point, we have a mutual agreement that any other wife I would have to okay.
Tot Sanjeev's verbazing verdedigen Lori en Ross nog steeds de polygamie in Short Creek.
Taking families away from several men that have had a moral problem.
Ook al hebben ze Warren's regime aan den lijve ondervonden.
There's no gatherings, there's no meetings, there's no entertainment, there's no books, sports.
Any media.
Any kind of
television, newspapers, magazines, radio, all that. You're not supposed to have nothing to do with it.
Perfect obedience produces perfect faith. It's one of the big quotations.
It was quite an eye-opener to hear Lori talking about polygamy. Ultimately, I think they're both deeply religious. They're both born and raised in this faith, and I think it's part of their DNA now. If that's what you believe from birth, then no matter how bad a man Warren Jeffs is, you're not just going to change your mind.
Ross en Lori Chatwin zijn nog steeds samen. Maar de meeste gezinnen zijn kapot gegaan door de Warren opgelegde regels. De volgende ochtend heeft Sanjeev een afspraak met Richard Holm, die zijn 2 vrouwen en 7 kinderen verloor toen hij in de ban werd gedaan.
Those are my 2 wives and that's our family.
Which one was the first wife?
Lorena.
Right.
And her and Alice are sisters.
They're sisters?
Yep.
Voor Richard werd het moeilijk toen Warren Jeffs profeet werd. Zijn volgelingen moesten zich bij hem verantwoorden over hun huishouden en ook over hun seksleven.
He said there should be no sexual relations between a man and his wife other than to bring forth children. Warren interferes in every element of people's lives. Some of my kids told me questions Warren has asked them. I do have a 22-year-old daughter now who, when she was 14, she got in some trouble. Warren asked her the intricate details of what you did to this boy and how you touched him and where you touched him and did you with your mouth and just the most graphic, gross questioning.
Toen hij hoorde dat hij uit de secte werd gezet, zocht Richard telefonisch de confrontatie met Warren Jeffs.
When he answered the phone, I said, Warren, this is Richard Holm. Why are you doing this to me? He said, I don't know. That's just what the Lord told me this very morning. It's too phony for words. But anyway, it went on that way for 6 weeks. When I get a phone call from my younger brother, Edson, and this wormy little bastard says that he is now married to my wives.
What was your reaction?
My reaction was, Edson, this is not right. This cannot be right. How could you go along with this shit? And he says, well, I don't know. I didn't know that the same thing could happen to me.
Richard Holm was ooit een van de succesvolste zakenlieden in Short Creek. Maar hij verloor zijn huis en zijn bezittingen toen hij uit de secte werd gezet. Al het land in Short Creek is in bezit van een financiële tak van de secte, de UEP, wat staat voor United Effort Plan. Bovendien moeten alle secteleden tenminste 10% van hun inkomsten aan de profeet afstaan.
I know in the last 25 to 30 years I've contributed all of $10 million into the community in the area.
And you put $10 million into that community?
Over that time frame, yes. I've paid $500 a month for years and years and years, just a tithing thing.
How much are people paying now?
Way more than just 10% tithing. It's all they can spare and then some. Warren is getting away with every bit of $5 million a month.
$5 million a month?
Yeah.
And that's just out of Colorado City and Hilton?
Well, out of the people, yeah.
Seems Richard believes that Warren's bleeding the Short Creek community of $5 million a month, which would mean, if it's true, that Warren is making $60 million a year. With that kind of power, he can get people in Short Creek to do pretty much anything he wants. I mean, he can control what they do with their money, as in give it to him. He can even control what goes on in the bedroom, determine when and probably how they have sex.
Sanjeev staat ervan te kijken hoeveel macht Warren over zijn volgelingen heeft. Maar als hij niet in Short Creek is, waar dan wel? De man die hier antwoord op kan geven is privédetective Sam Brower. Hij heeft de laatste 3 jaar onderzoek verricht naar Warren Jeffs en de FLDS. Sam heeft opnamen van de preken van Warren die verspreid worden onder zijn volgelingen.
I understand that on occasion they'll bring a tape of Warren in, you know, of him giving a message to the priesthood body. Sort of like the Osama bin Laden tapes, you know, every once in a while.
Sanjeev krijgt nu voor het eerst de stem van Warren te horen.
Filthy people.
There we go.
What is that? Black people?
Uh-huh.
So I give this lesson on the black race, that you can understand its full effect, the way they think, what they do, because you can trace back and see a connection with immoral, filthy people.
You can't get away saying things like that.
Yeah, well...
That's Nazi. Does he like Jews? What does he think about Jews?
No, he doesn't like Jews either.
What does he think of Hitler?
One of his favorite books is Rise and Fall of the Third Reich.
I'm liking him less and less, actually, I have to say. Since I've come to your office, Sam, he's really gone down in my estimation. Killing for the Prophet?
Mm-hmm.
What's that?
I'll play it for you.
You cannot change what the Prophet said. We are going to have the judgments very soon. Very soon. And we have got to be prepared. I'll tell you what a righteous man does if he's called to fight in a battle. He goes humbly, but he's asking the Lord to strengthen his hand so he can do the Lord's will.
Okay, that was
that one. That was so creepy. He's basically sanctioning murder at that point, isn't he?
Yeah, as long as it's for righteous reasons, if the Prophet tells you to.
Volgens Sam verplaatst Warren zich voortdurend. Hij blijft nooit langer dan een paar dagen op dezelfde plek.
Where do you think he is now?
There's a good chance he's in Canada.
Which part would he be in?
Just across the Idaho border.
British Columbia.
Mm-hmm.
Warren verkondigt onheilsprofetieën en hij zet aan tot moord. Hij is veel gevaarlijker dan Sanjeev in het begin dacht. Nu is hij misschien naar Canada gevlucht om zich schuil te houden bij een andere secte. Dus Sanjeev reist af naar Canada. Sanjeev is op zoek naar Warren Jeffs. Hij is profeet van de polygame sekte FLDS. Jeffs wordt gezocht door de FBI. Hij zou hier in British Columbia in Canada zitten, net over de grens met de Verenigde Staten. Als Warren hier zit, kan hij zich maar op één plek schuilhouden. Polygamie is verboden in Canada, maar ver weg in de bergen bevindt zich een polygame enclave Bountiful.
I'm hopeful that they won't be as hostile here in Canada as they were in Short Creek. But, you know, after Short Creek, I guess I'm ready for it.
Maar als Sanjeev in Bountiful aankomt, is zijn angst meteen verdwenen. Hij wordt niet achtervolgd en kinderen vragen hem of hij mee wil spelen. Bountiful wordt geleid door Warren's aartsrivaal Winston Blackmore. Deze zou zelf 25 vrouwen hebben en meer dan 100 kinderen. Warren heeft hem 3 jaar geleden verstoten.
So you're not a prophet in the same way that Warren Jeffs considered himself a prophet.
I don't consider Warren Jeffs to be a prophet either. He has absolutely no regard for the only thing that matters in the world, and that's people. Warren loves to be pursued because he can sneak around, he can have bodyguards, and he has spies all over the place. And they tap phone lines.
I think your phones have been tapped?
I think they know everything I'm doing.
Hoe vredig het er ook uitziet, Bountiful is een verdeelde gemeenschap. Bijna de helft van de mensen hier steunt Warren nog. Ze zouden hem best een schuilplaats kunnen bieden.
What about people who are not necessarily followers here, but who live here? Would they inform the authorities of that?
I don't know, but I know that I wouldn't.
So that would presumably mean that you think the charges against him are baseless.
That doesn't presume that at all. To actually do the very least damage that you could do to those people would be to let him still be at large. Because if they catch him, they'll make a martyr out of the guy and nothing will change.
Do you think that Warren Jeffs has ever come to Bountiful?
I think he's here.
Now?
We feel like he's here.
Winston is niet bepaald de aangewezen persoon om Warren's verblijfplaats te onthullen, maar Sanjeev is wel verbaasd door de ontwikkelingen. Als zelfs Warren's gezworen vijand hem niet wil aangeven, voorspelt dat niet veel goeds.
I may have got quite close to finding out where Warren is. I wouldn't be surprised if he's hiding here, but one thing's clear: no one's going to give him up here, whether they're pro-Warren or anti-Warren. When it comes down to it, fundamentalists stick together.
A small West Texas town is on edge this morning, wondering at the meaning of a possible doomsday cult threat.
Twee dagen later is er nieuws. Warren is hier misschien niet meer. Een paar van zijn 80 vrouwen zijn gesignaleerd in Texas, in het stadje El Dorado.
We have 3 convenience stores. We still have 20 churches, I think.
1 hardware store. In this taxidermy shop where we're at now.
Everyone knows everyone. Everyone's almost related to everyone.
We're in the middle of the Bible Belt. You know, we're kind of in the... In fact, we're the buckle of the Bible Belt.
In november 2003 kocht de FLDS onder een valse naam een ranch 6 kilometer ten noorden van El Dorado.
People got in a big uproar whenever they started moving in. They thought it was going to be the end of the world.
I believe that anyone who would come in on a lie cannot be trusted.
If they want to practice polygamy, go somewhere where it's legal or start their own country. They got enough money. Go buy Guatemala or somewhere and go down there.
Sanji wil uitzoeken waarom de FLDS de ranch heeft gekocht. Deze man weet dat misschien. Randy Mankin werkt bij de plaatselijke krant. Het land is officieel gekocht als jachtterrein voor $1 miljoen... door een van Warren Jeffs naaste medewerkers.
He told them he was a businessman from Utah and gave them his business card and, you know, said he was putting in a hunting ranch and it was all very believable. And then the construction started.
Het blijkt dat de FLDS een tempel op het terrein bouwt ter waarde van $25 miljoen.
So what's that thing in the middle?
That's the foundation where the temple is being dedicated. And we believe that is Warren Jeffs leading the dedication ceremony. That's what the site looked like a week later.
Wow.
1 week after that.
God, they don't hang around.
3 weeks in. They have the shell.
There it is. Yeah. In a month.
A month and 2 days. He is putting together his most loyal group here. And he named the ranch YFZ, Yearn for Zion. And in their teaching, Zion is the place you want to be.
Is the place you want to be here or in the next life?
Both.
Both.
De inwoners van El Dorado weten van Warren's onheilsprofetieën en van het feit dat hij tot moord heeft opgeroepen. Waco is maar een paar uur rijden van El Dorado en de massale zelfmoordactie in 1992 ligt nog vers in het geheugen.
These people are fanatical about their religion. And I don't want the name El Dorado to be synonymous with towns like Waco and Jonestown. I just hope events don't push people into doing things that aren't smart.
I'm dying to get inside that temple. I wonder what they got in there.
Then you may die if you go in there.
Volgens Randy kun je de tempel alleen vanuit de lucht bekijken. Jimmy Doyle is rechter in El Dorado. Hij is ook piloot en biedt Sanjeev aan over het tempelcomplex te vliegen.
Incredible, the size of this temple. So
almost like this is a new village. It's a new. It's not even part of El Dorado. It's going to have its own name.
De gemeenschap heeft een aantal enorme huizen neergezet op de ranch van 700 hectare. Die kunnen honderden mensen huisvesten.
Kind of wonder why here though. Why Texas? Why El Dorado? Why there? Yeah.
Sanji wil uitzoeken of Warren zich nu daar bevindt. De volgende dag praat Sanjeev met de enige man in El Dorado die op de ranch is geweest, de sheriff.
Oh, nice, you got two.
And a shotgun.
Hij is weliswaar op de ranch geweest, maar nooit in een van de gebouwen.
Do you have any information from your sources that would suggest that Warren Jeffs has been in and out of this compound?
We feel like, based on our resources, that he's been out here in the past.
So that means they know where he is.
You would think they'd know where he is, but I feel like there's only a certain select few that know exactly where he's at.
Now, he's a wanted man on several charges at the moment. Are mm-hmm. you specifically keeping an eye out for him visiting here?
Yeah, we're just doing what we do with anybody that has a warrant. If we come across him, then we'll definitely take action. And if not, you know, we'll just continue on.
Sanjeev twijfelt eraan of de sheriff en zijn mannen eigenlijk wel hun best doen.
Waco's in Texas,
mm-hmm.
and David Koresh had his last stand. Do you think Warren Jeffs is making his last stand here?
Yes, it's very similar. It's a religious sect. They're behind closed gates. But we're not getting any indication that this could be leading to a Waco. But, you know, there's a lot of people involved in this group, and there's no telling what extent they'd actually go.
Right.
Yeah.
Under what circumstances would there be forced entry?
If there's a felony warrant out of the state of Texas, and we definitely have information that the person is in there, credible information, that would be an indication that you could go in for forced entry.
Sanjeev denkt dat de autoriteiten ervoor terugschrikken om in te grijpen. Met Warren's onheilsprofetie in het achterhoofd voorspelt de naam van de ranch, Verlangen naar Zion, niet veel goeds.
They could be a lot harder on the FLDS and Warren Jeffs than they're being. And I think the reason that they're not, it's Waco. And if you think about that, it's horrific. If there's 600 people out there on that ranch, most of them women and children, many pregnant women. A mass suicide on that ranch doesn't even bear thinking about.
Sanjeev heeft geen enkele aanwijzing dat Warren in Texas is. Sanjeev's onderzoek lijkt dood te lopen. Dan krijgt hij een telefoontje van een lid van de familie Jeffs. Warren's neef Brent Jeffs heeft net een aanklacht ingediend tegen zijn oom. Sanjeev zoekt de 22-jarige Brent op in Salt Lake City, waar Warren hoofd was van een FLDS-school voordat hij profeet werd.
Yearbooks from my school years.
So is Warren in here?
Yes, Warren is.
So.
Oh, look.
Yeah, there's Warren right there. He's up on stage doing a skit.
Like a comedy thing.
Yeah, their church comedy thing, yeah.
See, he's the one that puts all these little funny comments.
Did he think he was quite a funny guy?
Well, he sure did. He was full of himself. He thought he was a hoot.
Oh, this is you right here.
With my missing teeth.
Were there happy days at school?
There were. I mean, I had some fun days with my friends. But, you know, for the most part, it was just school. We didn't enjoy it very much, you know. So.
Brent beschuldt Warren ervan dat hij door hem is misbruikt toen hij 5 jaar was.
We had like a Sunday class. The classes would separate, and so the kids would go down and play into their little play areas. The adults would stay upstairs. He would come downstairs and grab me by my wrist and take me into the bathroom. He was. It's hard. He would have anal sex with me. How many times did this happen in total?
It's happened quite a few times.
Only on Sundays?
Yes.
Did Warren give you a reason? Was it a punishment?
He said, this is God's will and this is a way for you to become a man. And I was so scared, I had no idea, and I thought this was the way that, you know, all the boys grew up this way, and that was just the way it was.
There might be some people mm-hmm. might think that you had other motives, joining the bandwagon now that Warren has various troubles with the law. What do you say to them?
They can believe what they want to believe, but I know, true to my heart, that I know what happened, and I'm going to come out and say what happened.
Sanjeev is ontzet door het verhaal van Brent. Toen Brent een tiener was, verliet zijn familie de FLDS. Brent neemt Sanjeev mee naar zijn vader, Warren's broer War Jeffs.
Pleased to meet you.
Pleased to meet you. I'm Sanjeev.
Thank you for your interest in us.
Yes.
Ward en Warren hadden verschillende moeders, maar groeiden samen op. Ward is 4 jaar ouder dan Warren.
What was he like as a brother?
He was always a bit of a mystery and took on a righteous air about him as of about 16, 17 and wasn't a very popular brother among all.
Was there anything that he particularly had against you?
I was the first of my brothers to have 3 wives. And he took some interest in my second wife, perhaps in an enviable way.
Ward denkt dat 4 van zijn zoons misbruikt zijn door Warren. De oudste, Klain, was van school gestuurd door zijn oom. Op 27-jarige leeftijd maakte hij een einde aan zijn leven.
He would become a frustrated boy and get into drugs unbeknownst to us for years. But it was in his final year of living that when he was admitted into a hospital for evaluation on an overdose. And his interview was recorded under hypnosis. The horror came out of that recording. And that was the first hint of any idea of abuse that showed up anywhere. Their mother lives with the deepest regret that she did not pick up on abuse at the time it was happening. And so this is why, as a family, we're in pursuit of justice in behalf of these boys. And it will never be granted for our son, Klain. But he's free in another life. And that's okay. And so, as a father of several of our victim children, I sit here to support the movement to capture and prosecute Warren to the fullest.
Appreciate you telling us your story. It's very sad.
There is no price big enough that he could pay, as far as I'm concerned.
Omdat Warren nog niet is opgespoord, is het nog niet tot een proces gekomen.
The story of the Brent Jeffs family, if it's true, and I know these are allegations and it hasn't been proven, but if it's true, I think they speak volumes about Warren Jeffs. It seems that he may have used religion as a tool all along, and that Religion might not be the driving force for Warren Jeffs. He might not be a religious delusionary. He might be a psychopathic narcissist.
Warren Jeffs is beschuldigd van kindermisbruik en staat op het punt zijn laatste stelling te betrekken. Het is van groot belang dat hij snel wordt gevonden. De FBI rapporteert dat hij is gesignaleerd in Florida. Zouden ze op het punt staan om Warren Jeffs op te pakken? Sanjeev is nu 3,5 week op zoek naar Warren Jeffs, een polygame sekteleider die beschuldigd wordt van zedenmisdrijven. Vanuit Los Angeles ging Sanjeev naar Arizona, Canada, Texas en Salt Lake City. Nu is hij in Florida aan de andere kant van de Verenigde Staten. Volgens de website van de FBI is Warren Jeffs hier gesignaleerd toen hij meer land wilde kopen.
It just doesn't look like a very Warren Jeffs type of place. I suppose anything's possible with Warren, you know, when it comes to hiding out. I mean, maybe Florida is so unlikely, it makes sense for him to be hiding out here.
Sanjeev wil het verhaal horen van de plaatselijke politie.
According to the FBI, they received information that he himself, as well as members of his organization, had physically been here in Lake County. We were unable to confirm that information or to verify it.
It's interesting that the FBI put that, they actually put Leesburg specifically.
Because that was the name they were given, was Leesburg, Florida.
But I mean, they put it on their website.
Why not?
Well, you tend to think that if they're going to announce it like that, then there must be something more to it than just...
If you are trying to track somebody down and you're trying to get him, you're going to try to corner him. And the best way to corner him is tell them everywhere you think he's been. Even if he hasn't been, he could be sitting back there laughing and saying, huh, we've never been in Florida. But guess what? We're not going there now.
Well, that's sneaky. You know, I feel like I've just come all the way here and I'm falling for it.
Well, not necessarily, because I don't know how credible their information is. They're not going to give that to us. We, you know, it's kind of on that, you ever heard the old saying, it's on a need-to-know basis, and we don't need to know. That's the way the FBI works.
Sanjeev is helemaal voor niets naar Florida gekomen. Hij heeft het gevoel dat hij door de FBI op een dwaalspoor is gezet.
Maybe it's in the FBI's interest to throw everybody off the scent. Maybe it's in the FBI's interest to send people like me via their website to places like Leesburg, where Warren Jeffs clearly is not. You can't control the FLDS from Leesburg in Florida. It's physically impossible.
You're watching the number one KSL5 Eyewitness News at 10.
Could Warren Jeffs have been in Lehigh today?
3 dagen later wordt Jeffs opnieuw gesignaleerd in Utah.
On the night before hunting, hunters pack Cabela's to get last-minute supplies. But it turns out the big catch might have already been in Cabela's. FBI agents were also able to get some kind of a surveillance tape from inside Cabela's here. They are working to see if they can identify Jeffs.
Sanjeev twijfelt eraan of ze Jeffs ooit nog zullen vinden. Hij wil duidelijkheid, dus hij gaat naar het hoofdkwartier van de FBI in Arizona. Waarom zou een voortvluchtige als Warren Jeffs zich in Utah laten zien? En dacht de FBI werkelijk dat hij in Leesburg was?
So we went to Leesburg and spoke to the Lake County sheriffs. With what you know of Warren Jeffs now and the stage of the investigation you're at, does it make sense to you that he might have been there? Is it logical?
No.
Do you think he's a sophisticated fugitive or that he could get caught outside a fishing shop?
I think he's a protected fugitive.
There are people in Short Creek that you suspect they may know where he is, and yet you have no way of getting that information from them.
That's true. And I'm sure they know where he is, some of them.
Have you heard that he's been there recently?
No, I have not heard any information that he's been there recently.
because when I was there a couple of weeks ago, I heard that he'd been there within the last 3 weeks to perform a marriage.
Okay, I had not heard that.
You not heard that?
No.
El Dorado. Have you been down there yourself?
No, I haven't.
You can't search their premises?
No, you cannot. They don't have to let us in there. They don't have to talk to us. They don't even have to open their door. And there's not a thing we can do about it.
But he's a criminal.
He is.
I thought they were tough on crime around here.
Well, when we catch him, I think we can be.
I just can't understand why he hasn't been caught.
At some point in time, I would hope that he would do something to one of his loyal followers that are going to upset them enough that they come to law enforcement.
So you're hoping for a mistake, or you're hoping for a dissident?
Yeah, essentially.
But it's hope, essentially.
Yes.
Sanjeev is een maand bezig geweest en heeft 13.000 kilometer kriskras door de Verenigde Staten gereisd. Hij weet niet meer waar hij nog naar Jeffs moet zoeken en geeft het nu op.
258. I don't think it's rocket science to find Warren. I think it can be done. And it's frustrating that I didn't, but it's even more frustrating that the people who should be finding him are not finding him. There's a really sordid underbelly to all of this. I've learned about embezzlement, families getting broken up, but it's the sex abuse, really. The way that he uses sex to dominate and oppress his followers. I think if you really take into account the allegations against him of sex crimes against children and the authority he has as a god figure, it just spells disaster.
Sanjeev wil met deze documentaire een waarschuwing afgeven. Als er niet snel iets wordt gedaan, worden de doemscenario's misschien wel werkelijkheid voor de FLDS. Inmiddels is Warren Jeffs gearresteerd. Maandag 29 augustus werd hij aangehouden bij een verkeerscontrole in Las Vegas.